Tell me, what do you do when you can no longer do what you've been doing all your life? What you learned from your father and your grandfather? I'm a fisherman in Guanabara Bay, near Rio de Janeiro, but maybe not for too much longer. Nothing has been the same since more than 1 million liters of oil leaked into the bay. Our waters are now the prize for the national oil company Petrobras, which is saturating the area with construction sites and terminals, building a gas pipeline. The companies claim to have a social environment responsibility, but they know what's going on and they don't take any action. The Clean Bay project is just for PR. And we're not here to clean up after them. We're up against a multi-million dollar construction business, and we are just poor fishermen. We need this sea to eat and to pay our bills. They're constantly trying to drive fishermen from the bay, but this is our bay. So we organized with the other fishermen of the area to demonstrate and to try to pressure local officials. In one demonstration, we were able to gather up to 100 men on their boats to protest. And when we are all together, we're strong and they don't make any direct threats. But when we go back home, when we go back to our routine, that's when the threats start. June 22nd was not a good day. Initially, when Almir and Pituca went missing, we weren't immediately alarmed, even though they'd already killed two other fishermen, Paulo and Marcos. But they didn't just kill Pituca and Almir. It was barbaric and cruel. They tied up our friends and left them to drown. They were drowned by the water that flows from the Guandaxiba River, the very river we are trying to save, the environment we're trying to preserve. They were in the way of a fucking pier. They are chasing us, hunting us, killing us. They kill us, and we bury our friends. And when we bury them, a little bit of ourselves goes with them. But we will not be driven out of our homes on Guanabara Bay. The choice is simple. Either we impose our will and survive, or we leave things as they are and use our boats as firewood to cook our last meal on the beach.